The National Catholic Prayer Breakfast showcases the light shining brightly in our world. Who would have thought that a breakfast among friends once a year in the nation's capital would become such a source of hope in otherwise deeply troubled times? In the face of a world on fire with crises, we must offer a common front in defense of the truth, strengthened by the real presence of our Lord in the Holy Eucharist.
This is the 20th anniversary of the first prayer breakfast, integral to what Pope Francis calls the delightful and comforting joy of evangelizing is the experience of praying together as you are doing this morning. May God bless your encounter today and your continuing witness.
Do not fool yourself that you're doing God's work just because you're working inside the church. You, God, your spiritual director, and your confessor know the brutal truth. Repeatedly assess yourself to make sure that you are a true disciple first. Do not worry about how many Thomas More awards you win while witnessing to Christ. You're probably not going to lose your head. Last year, I got 3, and I am still here with my head firmly attached, gratefully speaking to you. So thank you for all of this, and God bless you.
I am from Nigeria. The violent persecution and numerous massacres in my diocese have increased exponentially since I was appointed as bishop and continue to do so. In spite of all of this, Nigerian seminaries and churches are full. Christian faith is growing in spite of the terrorists, or maybe because of them.
Pray as if your life depended on it, because in fact, their lives depend on it. For our protection and an end to this, we know that evil fears when Christians gather to pray. Therefore, since the devil fears our prayers, let us therefore pray now for persecuted brothers and sisters in all countries, remembering especially those in Nigeria.
Think of it, be it done to me according to your word. Our Lady's response to the request of the angel Gabriel reversed the course of human history. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord, Mary says. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked with favor on his lowly servant. She who is now bearing her son, body, blood, soul, and divinity, is rejoicing in every part of her being. Is that not going to draw other people to Jesus Christ, my brothers and sisters? It is the most powerful and compelling invitation. So next time when you receive Holy Communion, before, of course, do a reverential bow. But I believe that after, a fist pump is in order. Praise be Jesus Christ.